What's up? It's just Lay, and I hope you guys are having a great day today. I know I am because I'm back with another video. So I'm starting this vlog off the night before because tomorrow I have clinicals and I have to get up early in the morning, and I know I'm not gonna feel like doing none of this, so I decided to go ahead and get everything prepped. So I'm just gonna show you guys what I'm doing the night before to get everything together, and yeah, hopefully tomorrow's a great day and hopefully I have a great first clinical experience. So ignore my little dorm setup. I'm so ready to get out of these dorms. But anyways, for clinical, I decided to pack a little wrap, and it just had some like hummus, some ham, some lettuce and cheese on it. And that's just what I decided to pack, and it was actually really good. So next I am prepping my clinical bag. This bag is from Pocket Nurse. I don't know if they sell this bag now, but like I'll put some links down below for some good clinical bags. This is also the bag I use for my clinical class. So there's a lot of things in here that I don't need, such as like a whole IV drip and like a whole catheter kit. Like I'm just clearing this stuff out and changing it to the stuff that I'm actually gonna need. So some of the stuff that I am bringing is like my stethoscope, my blood pressure cuff, of course. I'm also gonna make sure I have my lotion. My hands are really ashy in here. Like I don't even know why I didn't put this lotion on right then and there, but make sure you have lotion in your bag. Of course, my reflex hammer, my tuning forks, pen light. This clinical site is more of a rehab facility, so it's gonna be general assessment based. So that's why I'm bringing things such as like tuning forks and reflex hammers. So this is another great thing to have as like a nursing student, just a clipboard that you can put your papers in. This also has cheat sheets that you can buy along with it, and I'll link them below because these are really good cheat sheets. I could see myself really using these in the hospitals and things like that. And yeah, so while I'm packing, I'm just finding needles and just things that I just need to take out before I go to this facility, before they think I'm stealing or something. No, I'm just playing. But on another note, here's a really cool clinical gadget that I think every nursing student needs to have. This right here is a compactable and foldable calculator that you can also draw and write with. I think it's so cool and so convenient because, you know, when you have to do medical math or drug math and, you know, show your instructor before you give drugs, it's just really cool to have it right there in your hand. Your calculator's right there and everything is just so easy. It also folds pretty small, so it fits right in my scrub pocket. Like I have it in my scrub pocket while I was at clinical and it fit perfectly. So I will definitely link it below so you guys can get it too. So I got my scrubs nice and clean. They're ironed, hung out, because my instructors will get on me for having wrinkles.
Okay, so everything is prepped and packed. My lunch is packed, my clinical bag is packed, my scrubs are set out, and everything is pretty much together. Tomorrow should be a pretty easy clinical day. I have done clinicals in the past when I was going to school and getting my CNA, so I kind of have experience working in nursing homes just from getting my CNA license. So the main assignment is to do, you know, a remnants interview on our patients and just, you know, find out more about them, their medical history, kind of how their life was, and, you know, practice documenting all of those things. So just to kind of help me better, because I know tomorrow I'm going to be all over the place. I'm probably going to be very stressed out, very anxious, very nauseous, like the whole nine. I just went ahead and decided to go ahead and write down all my questions, write down places for me to put, you know, my pulse, respirations, temperature, vital signs, all of that, just so like when I'm there I have something to reference to like remind myself what I'm actually supposed to be doing, because my mind will totally go blank when I'm under stress. So that's just kind of something that I decided to do. And yeah, so I know I'm probably doing a lot and I'm probably being very extra, but that's just how I am. I'm very extra and I just want things to be perfect. So that's why I'm just like doing all this extra stuff the night before, because I'm really, you know, scared, not scared, but just a little bit nervous, anxious for clinicals tomorrow. I just want things to go right, nothing to go wrong. So that's why I'm just like prepping so much stuff and probably just packing things I don't need and just doing things that I probably just don't even need to do.
Okay guys, so it's the next morning, meaning it's officially clinical day. It is 8:02 on the dot and I am ready. I have to be there by 9. It's about 20 something minutes away. So I'ma have to get my stuff together. The only thing I hate is the fact that we have to drive ourselves, because I hate having to find directions. Like I hate having to find my place and find my way, but I guess I'm gonna just put it in my phone and it'll be fine. But I got my lunch, I got my clinical bag. The only thing I don't have is the thing for my name, like my name badge, little extendable thing. But they gonna have to be okay because I don't have that. Okay, y'all, so we made it to a little nursing home or whatever, and I'm actually not as nervous as I thought it would be. Like, I thought I would be really nervous, but I'm not. Like, maybe it's because I already like worked at a nursing home.
Yeah,
but I'm not nervous at all, so that's a good sign.
These are just some of my classmates before clinicals. You know, I can't film inside the facility, so this is just us waiting to start our clinical day.
Hey y'all, so I am back from clinical, and today was a pretty good day. So as y'all know, I couldn't film in the facility at all. I mean, I couldn't even have my phone out or anything, which makes a lot of sense. I mean, you have to protect your clients, your patients, and all of that. Today was just an easy day. Like I said before, we were just doing a reminiscence interview, just asking them some questions about their lives, taking their vital signs, and just helping them with anything that they needed for today. So it was very, very chill. And I think that's why I was so calm, because I kind of already knew that it wasn't going to be too much, but also I have like experience working in nursing homes, so it was honestly just a good experience. Of course, I can't really talk about everything because HIPAA, but at first I was assigned to somebody who spoke Spanish, and I was like, I need a new patient because I don't know how to speak Spanish. And it was funny because I was literally just like, como estas, like that's all I could say. That is all I could say because I did not know nothing else to say. But overall, my interviews and everything went really well. The vital signs went really well. I felt really good about it. I was one of the first people to finish everything, which also was cool. And I got to like finally look in, like, you know, some documentations and some medical charts and just medical history of my patients. So that was cool. And yeah, just to see everything that, you know, we're coming together from just what we learned in class and just seeing it, you know, in different ways while I was actually at the facility was also cool. And I would just say it was a really good clinical experience, like first time clinical experience. I know I did clinicals before, but I just feel like it's totally different now that I'm in nursing school and I'm just learning more. But yeah, people had all different stories of just things that was going on with them, and you know, just struggles that they had while they were just trying to work with their patients. But it's just part of the job. You have to learn how to talk to people, you have to learn how to deal with different types of patients. So yeah, anyways, I'm just gonna end off this video here. Like I said, it was just a successful day, and of course check out more of my nursing content that's on my page. I have a whole playlist of nursing content, so you know, if you're interested, just, you know, go ahead and watch more of my videos and also subscribe. Don't ever hesitate to reach out to me on Instagram, and you know, you can follow me on Instagram, social media, comment something down below, anything really. I'm very open to responding to people and, you know, answering questions. But yeah, I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know what y'all want to see next. I know y'all enjoy nursing content. I mean, I've just seen that from my past few videos. So just let me know what you want to know next, or anything that y'all would like to see. But other than that, I hope you really enjoyed it and have a great day. Bye.